All right, another thing I have been avoiding more from just getting onto the body of the car is the doors. They've been sitting around for a while now, and they really need me to get into them and start pulling them apart. They weigh a ton, so I'm going to have a look and see exactly what's in them and how I can lighten them up, because they're really, really heavy. Yeah, the next step is to strip them all back, see how much rust I've got. There is a little bit of rust in the doors. That's going to have to be sorted out. So yeah, we'll see how it goes. All right, I just made a little discovery. The doors are not as quite as nice as what I'd hoped. If you have a look down here, I'll just come down here, you can see that there's not a lot under here, so I'll have to investigate a little bit further to see if I can patch it or whether they're just too far gone and I have to replace them. But I'm hoping I can just build up some replacement panels and replacement pieces and just see how they go. So we'll have a look into a bit further. Here's another bit in the corner here. Quite nasty indeed. So that'll take a bit more investigation, I think. All right, so I've come outside to my very neglected and overgrown backyard to strip this door down. I thought better keep the mess outside than being in the garage. Oh, we have helpers come down to assist. But yeah, so I'll keep the mess outside here and see what we've got underneath these doors. Whew. That took a lot longer than I thought. I spent about an hour and a half just stripping back one door, taking the paint off one door. The amount of bog that was on there was amazing. I can now see where a lot of the weight must have come from. If you have a look closely, I'll show you in here. Look at the depth of the dents that they just filled up with bog in here. It's, as I said, subsequently taken me a couple of hours. There's also down this bottom edge, you can see where they've done some repairs. There's some repairs here and along here, and I believe what I'm probably going to end up doing is welding a new strip along the base. I'll cut it off and weld a whole new strip on. Alright, I've marked out the panel I'm going to cut out of the car now. What I've left is this small lip along the edge here. I decided I might try and see how it goes welding it back onto that, as opposed to cutting out the entire piece and rewrapping it underneath the door like the door skin originally is. If I can just keep that there, then I can keep the outer shape of the door like it stands and just run with it. So I'll cut that off and see how bad the rust is inside and see if I can make a replacement piece for it. I've never done it before, so it's going to be a challenge. Let's see how it goes. All right, let's have a look at what I was dealing with. Now I've cut the panel out. You can have a look here and you can see how much rust is on the back of that panel. So obviously it was just flaking through, and you can see here where they just tacked a patch over the top of a big rust hole. So that was never really going to do anything decent. It was just putting a lipstick on a pig. All right, I've just finished doing the rust treatment on here. I just used some rust converter, just some basic stuff from my local auto shop, rust converter, and some internal cavity rust proofing spray is what I'm about to spray on here. I've just gone through, I sanded back all the rust and used the rust converter on it, and now it's time to actually go through there, spray the rust proofing. Yeah, we'll get into it. All right, I've just cut out a couple of little patches of rust just here. They were bubbling through on that section along there, and that little box there as well, which I have over here. So these are the pieces I cut out. As you can see, they're quite rusted. So my challenge now is to take this piece, which has got a curve in it all the way along, if you can see that, and I've cut out a piece of this steel, a fair bit larger than what I need, and I'm going to attempt to bend it in the vise, etc., to try and replicate that, and then I can hopefully cut out a matching piece of metal and weld it in. See how that goes. All right, now, as you can see, I've taken the little rusted piece and I've marked it out onto my curve that I beat out on this little trial piece. I've scribed it onto here, and now I've got to cut it out and then see if we can weld it in. All right, here's my first trial piece, and as we can see, it's a little bit too big a gap around the edge, so I think it's back to the drawing board, and I'll see if I can make a better one. Well, the first little rust patch turned out pretty good, actually. I'm pretty happy with it. Here's the finished patch. The only issue I found was when I started grinding it away, I didn't grind back this part of the door before, and there's a lot more rust all the way along that I'm now going to have to patch as well. But right now, I'll get on to doing this little square patch hole here with a seam through the middle of it. So let's move on to that one. All right, you can see that's a nice tight fit there on that patch piece. And there we go, all patched up. And another patch tacked in. And there's another patch done. So most of that bottom edge is looking pretty good now. All right, now you can see I've made up a patch panel for the front. And after a bit of playing around, it's quite a nice even fit. So, all right, I'm pretty happy with that. I've just cut this panel out and welded it in. It's just tacked in at the moment. I can go back later and weld in between all these gaps and fill it in gradually. But basically, it's come out quite nicely. It's quite even. There's not much warpage on the main panel itself. It feels pretty good. This is a little bit low here, but it's much better than what was there before. They just patched over the top of the rust. Now the rust is gone. Nice new panel in there. And considering if it wasn't for repairing it, the doors would be a throwaway anyway. I'm pretty happy. So come back next time I get into it. I'll get in and weld in between these and grind it all back. And then I'll tackle getting the vents out of the door. And then that's one door done. So fair bit of work, but saves me throwing them away and going to buy new doors. All right, well, now you can have a look and see. I've finished welding in the panel and grinding everything back, and it's all looking reasonably good, but there's quite a low here, and it's proud here. As I've welded it, it's stretched and shrunk the metal a bit. So basically what I've got to do now is I'm getting the hammer and dolly, and I'm going to go in underneath and try and get this back out to a nice shape. And I'm also going to go through these large dents here and see if I can bring them all back into looking a bit tidier. Right, now I'm going to start the next door. This one's got a little bit more complicated damage than the other one. You can sort of see here there's quite a bit of rust in the bottom here and patches, and I've marked out where I'm going to cut out the panels to replace the rusted areas. This area here is quite a bit more complex because of the compound curves here. This corner here is quite badly rusted through on both sides because they just chucked a big lump of bog in there. That's just bog in there, so I've got to cut that out and make up some patch panels. This one here has got a circular lump, so I'm going to have to try and recreate that somehow. We'll see how that goes. So because this is such a complicated shape, I've had to use a cardboard template, and I've gone backwards and forwards a couple of times, but I've made up a cardboard template of the piece that I want to take out. So that there, I've made up, and I'll transfer that onto a piece of sheet metal and cut it out and try and bend it into the shape to get these complex curves and weld these corners together so that it comes out in the shape of the piece that I'm looking for. One, two, three, four, love your hands. One, two, three, four, love your hands. One, two, that was about half an hour of cutting and shaping, but you can have a look here and see that it actually is quite a good fit, the piece that I've just made up. And here it is, all installed. It's welded and I've ground it back, as you can see there. I did a couple of plug welds here to join it onto that sheet metal panel that was under there, and also did the big drain hole that's here and welded it on. Okay, these ones were a pain in the backside, but you can see I've sort of made two pieces there and made a bit of a ball. It's not exactly the same as the standard one, but it's the best I could sort of get it up with the hammer and dolly and sort of trying to manufacture it. And you can see the corner patch right here. All right, now you can see where we've made these panels up in here and welded them up, and it needed to look like a sort of a round ball like that, and it's reasonable. Once I finish tidying it up, do some bit of body filler and stuff on it, it will look nice and decent, and I mean, it's under the door trim anyway. The rest of the panels are pretty good. All this corner's all welded in. Alright, that's the end of several days' work now, trying to cut and patch all that rust out of the doors. Considering they were a throwaway if I didn't get them fixed, I think they've come out okay. Another first for me, giving a go sort of making some replacement panels. Some of them were a little bit more complicated than others, and I think they came out pretty good overall. I'm pretty happy. So. That's the doors pretty much done. A little bit more hammer and dolly work, as I said, but I'll work my way through it.